Right, so apparently I've been invited onto the M. Dickey show. Whatever the shit that is. I, like many, find Jeremy Kyle and Jerry Springer like shows to be rather a guilty pleasure. I wouldn't say that they're good for you, and it's probably a bad idea to ever start getting into them, because watching more than one a week is just depressing as fuck. But every now and then, it's sometimes fun to just relax and watch two people who you have no respect for fight about something that you don't care about. It's kind of like watching the Colosseum in ancient Rome, and it's totally not a mark of our society crumbling. M. Dickey also had a similar belief towards these shows, and decided that he wanted to make his own version of the show. But that wasn't even the beginning of his ambition. He wanted to make it into a video game. Now, M. Dickey, as you may remember, was the guy who made the U Testament and Making of a Prophet, and a load of wrestling games, and a couple of other things that I hope to cover in due time. However, he might have come up with the greatest concept for a video game of all fucking time with this one. The M. Dickey Show. Jeremy Kyle, the beat-em-up. This man is a fucking genius. So, this game is very similar in style and gameplay to the U Testament and Making of a Prophet, oddly enough. Except in this game, it's more like a backstage brawl in WWE. At a guess, I'd say it's a repurposed wrestling game of M. Dickey's, as he's made quite a few of those in the past. The game is structured around a moral choice system in which you move up and down a ladder depending on whether or not you've picked the good or bad option. I don't really like this, or even think that it's necessary, but I'll explain why later. The way that each show typically works is that the player picks their side, and after there's a massive argument, the player gets up and beats the shit out of the other one. In the opening, you see these two guys debating as to whether or not M. Dickey is a good game developer, and then a sign drops on the guy who took M. Dickey's side. I don't know why M. Dickey saw as fit to punish the person defending his game over the other one who was trashing it, but maybe he's just a true believer in criticism and free speech. Which could be the case, actually. I've not heard of M. Dickey doing anything in regards to censoring criticism or anything twatish like that. So, he's respectable on that ground, given that, you know, it's become quite a problem among certain indie developers at the moment. So, you basically pick a side at this point, and I'm not really a fan of how you pick your side either. You see, you pick the side before seeing the debate, so you don't know what you're picking. I usually pick the side that I agreed with, just by accident, but they don't tell you anything about the debate itself, and you don't see the debate itself until you've picked your side. Morality is a very subjective thing, and you might agree with the bad guy on a few occasions and may want to pick him, but the game doesn't really allow you to make that decision once you've committed. And it's more like picking your character. This is fine, I guess, but it really could be better. I'm glad this game came out before these kind of shows just turned to shit into an hour of catch-ups. Honestly, if you watch daytime TV now, you just constantly get reminded of what you just watched. Can't Pay Will Take It Away is a show I've watched once or twice over the past 6 weeks that I've been off work. And given that I'm downstairs with my coffee and breakfast, and I'm not really in the mood to do anything else, it's a nice bit of brain rot to enjoy whilst I'm off and just relaxing in the morning. But the show isn't very good, and it's mainly down to the fact that it's a massive fucking waste of time. And I am fully aware that these shows were a massive fucking waste of time to begin with, but majority of this show is what has already happened being repeated to you. Like, I know that Fuckface is having his stuff taken away. That's the point of the show. Get on with it. They even repeat things that they've shown earlier on in the week. basically making it that two episodes show the exact same event, along with new events, to recycle shit, mere days after airing it as well. You can sometimes see the same story three times a week. Some shows like this even go as far as to mislead the audience in what is about to show up to keep their attention. Honestly, I'd recommend watching anything or doing anything else nowadays. It's just junk food for the brain, and I'd recommend porn over it at this point. At least you can learn something from porn, and you know that somebody's gonna get fucked in the end, and there aren't as many ads. Though I would recommend Mystery Diners because that shit's hilarious.
Dang it!
So my first story is this guy who's been dragged onto national television just to be fired. And of course, because he can't read the massive fucking letters up on the screen, he has to wait for his boss to deliver it to him vocally, live on television. Presumably national television. I think it's really a bit of a nitpick, but M. Dickey forgot to capitalise most of the I's here. I don't know why. He was oddly enough brought onto national television to be fired simply because he's been a two-timing jackass with other companies. Which is, reasonable I guess if it's true. He's apparently been doing dodgy deals with the enemy in quotations. And so, as a result, the pink tank top dude dispenses justice.
You can't have me, nobody can. Is that your deal? Well, you know what? I see you brought me out on TV. Hoping that I wouldn't make a big deal, hoping that I wouldn't make a scene. Well, you know what, you chose the wrong show for that. You see, the M. Dickey Show is all about making a scene. It's all about justice and getting what's...
And wait, why is he wearing knee pads and wrestling attire? He's bullshitting, he was prepared for this. Oddly enough, the guy who sold his boss out is the good guy in this scenario? Maybe M. Dickey has an anti-corporate thing going on here, who knows. The controls are the same as in New Testament and Making of a Prophet, but in all honesty, it's a little better than those games, as it's actually designed to be a brawler beat-em-up, and so it works like one. It's not perfect though, in fact, it's not really very good at all. I found myself furiously mashing keys to get myself to do anything, like I was playing a classic SmackDown game. I accidentally assaulted M. Dickey himself a few times after being helped by him, which, for the record, I am sorry for. I hate that I hurt such a visionary in my blind rage and confusion, but in truth, the real reason that I did this is that the targeting is fucked. I honestly couldn't find the manual targeting button and pretty much just had to keep moving in front of the person I wanted to hit whilst targeting another. I wasn't able to escape locking onto an enemy. The fight's cut short when I hit the wrong key. I think it's the escape key. But anyway, instead of pausing the game like I'd hoped, it sends me back to the menu without even asking me if that's what I want. Oh. Shit.
Tonight on the M. Dickey Show, Ross does not have a clue.
Hi, I don't really know why I'm here.
Is Kylie going to get her man?
Actually, I think Kylie might be the man.
If you don't want to marry me, then screw you! Right? If I can't have you, nobody can.
Find out who will win in this battle of brain and heart.
I got a bottle of milk in my fridge that I've had a long relationship with.
On the M. Dickey Show.